Sam, maybe enough cartoons for today. It's our third one already.
It's movie night, not movie hour. We'll be watching them all night.
Yeah, right. This one with the angry birds will be the last.
Okay, fine.
Sam!
What?
Where did all the popcorn go?
No idea. It just fell out even. I didn't even notice.
And as usual, you didn't even think about me.
Quiet! An interesting moment.
Sam!
Shh! Oh, my feta!
What?
Sue, how did he get inside the egg?
Well, he's a bird, and birds hatch from eggs.
That's nonsense. Birds grow on trees in nests.
They live in nests, and they come from eggs.
Oh, there's so little room in there! And so dark.
That's it, Sammy. Let's go to bed.
Sue, can birds hatch from the eggs in our fridge?
No. To get a baby bird from an egg, you need a mother bird to hatch them.
Hatch them? How?
Well, roughly speaking, sit on them.
Oh, we don't have a bird. Will a cat do?
No, there's another way. At poultry farms, they put eggs in a special incubator that provides conditions necessary to grow hatchlings. Warm temperature and humidity.
Interesting.
All right, nature boy, go to sleep. You won't hatch anything from grocery store eggs.
Won't hatch anything. If I'd always listened to you, I wouldn't have had my channel. Where are the eggs? Not here. How about... nope. Dessert. I'll get back to you later. Aha! Here are the eggs! Are you cold, little ones? Don't be sad. Papa Sam will warm you up and our viewers will give us a thumbs up, right, guys? Sit on eggs. I can do it myself. I'll just put an egg right here. And another one! Hey, hatchling! Trying to run away from Papa? Okay, yes, that's better. Hey guys, do you think I'll get hatchlings? Pause the video and leave a comment below. I wonder how much longer I should sit like this. I need to face the facts. I am not a bird. And what does that mean? Well, that's right. We need an incubator. What did Sue say? Right. Warmth and humidity. Here's your warmth. And I'll wrap you to keep you safe from drafts. And a bit of humidity. Here, my babies. Papa Sam is ready to do anything for you. Let me hug you. Oh, it seems like only yesterday Sue and I met, and our family's already growing.
Oh! Sam! When did he do this? Sammy, have you been sleeping here?
Sad bird. Oh, stay.
Sammy, wake up!
Stay! Birds! Why? Where are my hatchlings?
You've still decided to try your crazy idea? Here!
Oh, no! Sammy's a bad papa!
Oh, no. Sammy, don't cry. Do you want a chocolate? Two chocolates? A box, perhaps? Do you want a home incubator?
Yes!
Listen, I've seen a draft on the internet. Let's try to do a science experiment.
Thank you, dear Sue!
Well, guys, we're going to build an incubator. Are you ready?
They need to subscribe first, and I'll send them a big digital kiss.
Guys, subscribe to the channel and hit the bell button to be the first to see all new episodes. And we'll start. First, we'll need some hard styrofoam, about 2 centimeters thick. Dear viewers, we strongly recommend you do this project only with an adult. Ask them to help. Watch this video as a guide from Sam and learn together with us. Let's measure 20 and 22 centimeters on each side. And cut this part with the help of a stationary knife. We'll need 4 parts, like this. Now, let's assemble a house out of 3 parts and connect them with duct tape.
Another one. Now for ducts 2.
It should be 20 centimeters wide, 24 centimeters high, and 22 centimeters deep. Now, let's glue these styrofoam strips inside. You'll understand later what it's for. And now, with the help of clippers, we need to cut a piece of metal grid the size of the bottom of our box.
Oh, let me clip! I'm a super clipper!
Oh no, Sammy, it's not for kids.
Kids? Where do you see kids here? I'm going to be a bird dad soon! Kids, really.
Now, we're going to need a plug, an adjustable switch, and a bulb with a socket. Our neighbor Roger helped me connect them, and you too, guys, should ask adults to help you!
Oh, that Roger. Guys, who helps you do crafts? Pause the video and comment right now!
Now, we can adjust the brightness of the lamp. Let's mark the places on one more part, where we'll insert the socket and the switch. Let's insert them carefully. Screw the bulb in. And there! And we'll make the last wall from transparent plastic so that
I can watch my babies!
Yes! Now we need to make holes for ventilation to make sure the eggs...
My babies!
Sam's babies don't suffocate. We'll make several holes in the upper part of the side walls. Again, ask an adult to help. And several at the bottom of the back wall.
Fluffy! Let me swaddle you. Please, it won't hurt a bit. Hey, what are you doing? Oh, are you mad now? Sue, Fluffy has gone mad.
Sam, quiet! This is an interesting moment. We'll make latches for the transparent wall. They're easy to make. Just bend the clips with the cutters. This is perfect. Now let's attach them here, so they can hold the wall. The bulb will help maintain the necessary temperature inside the incubator, but humidity is also important.
We need to water them!
Sam, they aren't plants! The eggs should stay dry. I'll put a flat container with water under the grid. We can monitor the temperature and humidity with this special sensor. Hey guys, did you know that different regions have different air humidity? I have a special task for you. Find out what the humidity in your region is and write in the comments!
By the way, guys, thank you so much for all the comments! I wake up every day, read them, and laugh out loud! Write more!
Meanwhile, our home incubator is almost ready! Let's close the door and wait until we get the numbers we need. Humidity should be around 50 to 55%. If it's too low, add another container with water. If it's too high, use a smaller container. And the temperature can be regulated with the help of the switch. We'll need to get it to 38 degrees.
38 degrees? That's a lot! They're running a fever in there!
It's the temperature of a mother bird. Just right. Ready? Now we can put the eggs in.
I'm coming!
I'll put a smaller grid inside and some hay for the setting.
Here they are, my sweeties. None of them have cracked.
Wow! Thank you, Sammy. You'll make a great dad. These are ordinary quail eggs from the supermarket. Before you put them in, you need to check them for cracks and add marks. It'll come in handy when we turn the eggs over. We need to do it regularly. For the next 3 weeks, we'll be watching the eggs and monitor the indicators. Hey guys, do you want to see the result of the experiment and know if we get hatchlings from supermarket eggs? Give a thumbs up if you do and write, "I want to see Sam's hatchlings." Hey Sam, what are you doing?
I'm setting up camp here. I'm going to watch my babies.
And the crazy bird dad and I will be waiting. Bye-bye. Hey guys, this experiment has really blown my mind. I want to see what we're gonna get. Give this video a thumbs up and don't miss part 2.